Now to an emotional story developing right now in Chicago. A young woman's account of her experiences as a lesbian student at the Moody Bible Institute is getting a lot of attention online. Tonight we spoke to her and also got the school side of the story. NBC5's Alex Maragos has more.
This is the tweet posted Friday by Moody Bible Institute graduate Megan Steffen. The "How It Started, How It Ended" tweet says she is lesbian and also shows a 2019 letter from administrators disciplining her for social media posts.
Even though the letter doesn't say, "Hey, we're punishing you and mad at you because you're a lesbian," it's very clear that that's exactly why I'm being repeatedly reached out to.
She says homophobia at the school is rampant and needs to be addressed.
When you discriminate against people for something they can't control, you deserve to be held accountable for that.
Former student Maddie Devon is also lesbian.
It was just like the loneliest place I think I've ever been.
Devon says she felt discrimination from all angles, leading her to attempt suicide before dropping out last year.
It makes you feel unsafe and fearful, and that feeling of community that all of your peers have, you don't have that.
The 135-year-old school says it can't comment on specific student experiences, but said in a statement, quote, "Our care for the student body, which is guided by God's word and a love for them as a unique person made in God's image, extends not only to their educational pursuits, but also their Christian maturity. We therefore continue to operate by our doctrinal statement, as well as a set of community standards, by which everyone personally affirms," unquote. It also referred to its binding student life guide, which on page 8 says same-sex relationships are sinful under any circumstance. Meanwhile, Devon and Steffen say they hope for change at Moody.
It's time for them to be held accountable for their actions and for the deep-seated pain they've caused so many people.
If it could be okay to be LGBT, you know, that would be amazing.
Reporting in the Gold Coast, Alex Maragos, NBC5 News.